Welcome to the learning support video on understanding electronegativity. We can utilize this term to understand how and why certain atoms behave the way they do as it pertains to ionic bonds, which involve the release and or gaining of electrons in order to achieve chemical stability. Let's consider that we have two atoms, both sodium, Na, and chloride, Cl. Sodium has 11 electrons, whereas chloride has 17. Some sources that you may review differ slightly in the number of electrons that are said to fit on each of the electron shells or valences. For our purposes, let's consider that the first shell can only accept 2 electrons, which is true across the board regardless of the source you reference. But let's consider that each subsequent shell can only house up to 8 electrons. So, as we begin to number our electrons for sodium, we now know that we can place 2 electrons on the first shell. The second shell, as we discussed, can hold up to 8 electrons. Now, since we have only 11 electrons, there is only one electron remaining that needs to be placed in order to appropriately depict the number of electrons for sodium. Now, we have an accurate representation for the atom or electron, sodium. The same will be true for chloride. We can place 2 electrons on its first electron shell. And just like sodium, the second shell will also be filled with 8 electrons. There are now 7 electrons that need to be placed since we have a total of 10. Remember that we can fit up to 8 electrons on the next shell. But after we place the first 6, only 1 remains, which leaves us just shy of being able to satisfy the octet rule. So what are we to do? How can we satisfy the octet rule for both of these atoms? The answer is, we have to refer to the term electronegativity. If an atom has a greater number of electrons, it has the ability to pull on the atom that has a lower number of electrons. In this way, if chloride pulls the last electron away from sodium, both sodium and chloride have a total of 8 electrons on their outer shell, satisfying the octet rule. Now, both atoms are stable. We have to now utilize appropriate notation to refer to both of these atoms. For sodium, we must now refer to it as Na+, because an electron has been removed from it. Think about it this way. Anytime we remove negativity from a person, we're making them more positive. So because we took away a negative charge, which is an electron, away from sodium, we should write it and refer to it as Na+. The plus actually represents the removal of a negative charge. The same has to be done with chloride. Since it has gained a negative charge, or an electron, we need to now refer to it as Cl-. The negative sign here represents the acceptance of a negative charge.